In this video tutorial, I will show you how to create and manage passwords for your advanced pay-per-view packages. In my first playlist, I have three videos, each supporting time restrictions. I will need to go to the PPV options for one of our videos, and select the correct package under Advanced Packages, and then navigate to Password Type and Generate New Passwords. Here I can choose to configure an expiry period, which is active from the moment of generation. In this case, I have selected 30 days. You can restrict the total number of allowed views within that month. In this case, I have selected 10 views. I have also limited the total number of views per video to 2, meaning that our viewer has 30 days to watch our videos and can watch them 10 times with a restriction of 2 views per video. Now here I have the choice to generate any number of passwords. In this case, I have chosen 5. And now, I will generate my new passwords and navigate to Save Generated Passwords. I now wish to manage my new passwords by selecting See Passwords, which will redirect me to a new browser window. The same management window can be found under PPV Orders and Passwords tab. Listed here are my 5 newly generated passwords. From here, I can select the password to give to any of my viewers. I can track which passwords have been assigned to which viewer simply by assigning them a tag. In this case, we have assigned this password to a viewer labelled Viewer 1. You have the option to edit your passwords, giving you the ability to modify their restrictions. In this example, I have extended the expiry period. To save these changes, I simply click Save Changes. We have created passwords, which have now been associated to the Time Restrictions package. Now let us see how our viewer will experience this by navigating to our playlist. Here you will see the videos which support our time restrictions package. I will click on the first video and enter our password, which will then allow me to view the video. If I attempt to use this password for a video that belongs to another advanced package, I will be presented with an error message informing me that I do not have sufficient access rights to access this video using this password. As you can see here in our example, these 3 videos belong to a separate advanced package, while these 3 videos belong to our time restrictions package, which I do have access to. I will now play this video again for a second time, and now, as I attempt to play the video for a third time, I am prompted to enter in my password again. If I return to our password list, you can see that I have reached the maximum number of allowed views, and have attempted to view the video 3 times, exceeding the maximum number of allowed views for that particular video. Now if I try to access another video in the playlist, I can access it once, twice, and the third time I am again prompted to enter a valid password. I can modify the permissions for each video by clicking here. In this case, I increase the number of views to 3. When I attempt to access the first video in our playlist again, you can see I'm now able to view the video, and if I try to view it again, I will be again prompted to enter my password, reflecting the changes we just made. So all changes made here are applied in our playlists in real time. You also have the ability to disable each password, blocking any further attempts by the user to use that password. By clicking the plus symbol, you'll be able to bring up activity data for that particular password or viewer, listing their IP address, the time and date the password was used, their country and origin, and much more. You can click here to enable the password, or here to disable the password. At present, this password is disabled. I can also permanently delete any password by clicking the X symbol. You can also filter the activity data, for example, by password type or package, and also customize the table layout by dragging and dropping them from here to there. We will be adding more columns to this table shortly. You can also export all these results to CSV by clicking here. Thank you for watching this video. More video tutorials are available on our website.